I cannot believe ChatGPT made us go here.
For the next 24 hours, ChatGPT is going to take full control of my M5. For this entire day, ChatGPT is going to decide what we do to, with, and for the M5 E60. Do to? Does that make sense? Yeah.
The future is now, nerds.
Let's get this opened up here, get some sunlight in. For the entire day today, we're going to ask ChatGPT questions about what to do to the M5, where to go with the M5, what to do for it, and whatever it says, we got to do.
So let's just start with something easy. Why don't we tell it that we drive an M5? I'm sitting in my BMW M5 E60. Send. What do you got to say about that, buddy? That sounds like a fantastic car, and then you're going to go into the history about it. So you know what it is. That's great. What should I do first? Familiarize yourself with the controls.
We're really starting on an absolute banger here. So I'm going to assume that means start the car. So just following orders here.
Give her a little plug.
Wouldn't be an M5 E60 video if I didn't film the cold start. There we go. Oh, beautiful. Step one done. Let's roll that up or we're not gonna hear anything else. Adjust my seat and mirrors. They're adjusted. Number three, connect your devices, already done. Go for a drive. Okay, I like that one. Where should we go? Part one says to go for a scenic drive. Well, we are at a half tank of gas, so what better scenic route to take than a nice little park drive to fill up the M5. Still got the Sprint Booster installed here. It's currently on Sport 5. Let's go for a scenic drive. Now, in case you don't know what ChatGPT is, if you've been living under a rock, it's basically an AI platform that communicates with you. You can ask it questions and it's gonna give you answers.
This looks pretty scenic to me. I think this'll do. You got the nice little ravine over here. Puppy off in the distance there.
I think we can check scenic drive off the list. Now, at one point during this video, and I'm kind of scared for it, I'm going to ask ChatGPT what mod I should buy next for the M5 E60. And this thing has a lot of historically expensive mods. So it could be a pretty expensive day, because whatever it tells me, I'm going to buy. It's going to tell me to buy like a new SA85 engine, because this one could just explode at any second. And if that's the case, I don't know if we can spend 15K today on an engine, but anything else, I'm committed to. We're back home. Let's see what ChatGPT has next on the list.
What will break next on my M5? E60, the golden question.
Because with this car, you never know, there's always something. And according to ChatGPT, the first thing on the list that's gonna break here is the Vano system. Great, that's definitely not a cheap repair, so nice.
Up next is the SMG transmission, also notoriously bad on the M5 E60, so credit to ChatGPT, it knows what it's talking about. Fuel injectors, again, that's something that's sort of easy. Cooling system, the S85 engine up there, known for being terrible with the cooling system. And what does it say at the bottom here? It's important to remember that these are general observations and not all vehicles will experience the same issue.
If you're in an M5 E60, all M5 E60s are gonna experience this issue.
Okay, let's go. ChatGPT is gonna decide my next car mod.
So what I did is I asked ChatGPT, what is the quickest, cheapest, and easiest mod for under $100 that I could do to my M5 E60 right now? And the answer was,
a quick, cheap, and easy mod under $100 to install on your M5 today are interior mods. Change up the look of your ignition button with a new color. add some ambient floor lighting or a seat cover to really change the look of the interior of your M5.
Hell no, we are not adding a seat cover or ambient floor lighting to this car. It would not work at all. But
our ignition button here, and it is getting a little faded, and the car is red. So I was thinking, I'm gonna grab a red ignition button to match the rest of the car. Something clean, simple, and it's gonna spice things up a little bit because this one has obviously been mushed to no end.
So, guess we're ordering an ignition button. Thank you to ChatGPT.
So I found one here on modbargains.com. I've got a few things for the M5 here, like the front matte black grille. And we have a red stop-start engine. I feel like that could look good with the M5 with the red seats here. I looked up the install. It's not too bad. Yeah. Also, price is $31.95.
It's not going to break the bank. One worth doing. Let's go ahead and order it.
Stop-start kit. We do not want the pry option. There's the button. We want it in red. We do not need an install kit. I looked up the install. You literally just take that old one out and put this one on. Go ahead and add that to cart. That's not bad at all. I'm going to proceed to checkout. Thank you, ChatGPT, for the $20 mod.
Obviously, I'm going to put in my info off camera, but in one of these next videos, I will show you, if I remember, to update you guys on the red ignition button install. It's literally like a 2-minute install. But that is the mod ChatGPT decided on for the M5 E60, a red ignition button, and we went ahead and bought it. So next I asked ChatGPT, what is your favorite part
about the BMW M5 E60?
And it said, as an AI language model, I don't have personal experiences or emotions, so I don't have preferences or favorites. However, I can appreciate the BMW M5 E60 for its powerful V10 engine, dynamic performance, luxury interior, and iconic design. The combination of high-performance capabilities, advanced technologies, and the overall driving make the M5 E60 a desirable car for car enthusiasts. Questionable, I agree.
But it did highlight the V10 engine, so now, of course, I gotta show it to you. Now, I know I've shown this in previous videos, but it never hurts to have a look. Ignore that. The M5 E60 S85 5-liter, 507 horsepower stock V10 beast of an engine. We literally have only been driving this for like half an hour today,
and I can feel the heat radiating off it
at my face right now. Now, I am not surprised at all why ChatGPT says this is the most well-known part of the car.
I think that's pretty much a given. This thing has given me so many good times on the road and so many bad with all the issues that it has, but I can tell you personally, it is really not that bad. For what it is and for how unique this car is, it is worth every single headache. And it seems like even ChatGPT knows that. As a car guy, another huge thing we always worry about, and I'm sure you do too, is car photography, taking photos
of our rides from the very best angles.
What should we do?
Should we do it down here? Should we go up top? What's the best angle? 3/4 angle, straight on.
Then you have the guys that say, turn your phone upside down, film this way because it's better for the stabilization. So many different things.
Do you tilt the roof or not in your photo?
The answer is always yes. Why don't we get some car photography tips from ChatGPT itself and see if it can improve my car photography skills during the 24 hours that this thing is going to control my car.
How should I take my next pick of my M5 E60? When taking your next picture, your BMW M5, oh my God, we're getting an entire Bible here. Pretty generic, but there is something that we can take away here. Choose a suitable location. It's gonna have to be this backyard. Focus on lighting. It's not overcast, so not ideal, but we're gonna make it work. Experiment with angles. This is the big one. Capture the car from low angles to emphasize its sporty stance, or elevated shots to showcase its presence.
That looks like shit.
on low angle.
Quite the collection we have at the back here. Lighting is not great. But I do like the 0.5 millimeter. That one's not bad. Don't like those. Couple of good ones here at the back. And then the vertical ones are actually not awful. Next destination, according to ChatGPT, is the Scarborough Bluffs here in Toronto. I guess that's where it thinks we should go. Let's take the M5 there. It's a super nice place, really good drive. Maybe I'll give you guys a little bit of POV action while we drive down through the curvy roads there. We're doing what it says. Off to the next base. It's day two of our ChatGPT controls my M5 video. And right now, the next step is go to the Scarborough Bluffs. It's like a waterfront road, super nice here in Toronto. And the car sounds great. Dad's moving the Porsche SUV out of the way so we can get out.
That's the biggest problem about having a nice little car collection. We got three more in the garage over there, is we have a
one lane driveway. And so trying to get these cars out of the way is, just to get one out is sometimes ridiculous. We call it musical cars.
The car sounds so good in second gear. It's got a couple of burbles, I think, once it like actually heats up. It just sounds so nice. Got a Maserati SUV over here. What do you guys think of that? I think Maserati looks nice, but I've heard that the build quality is just not up to par with that price and that reputation. But we're heading to Scarborough Bluffs right now. Gonna show you guys a nice little drive. It's a bit of a windy road, goes right to the waterfront, because we got that, and then tons of new mods coming to the M5, like our red button starter. This car is feeling good today and sounding good. We are getting close to our destination. Sidewalks here are really, really weird. I don't know why they have this giant bump there. But it's also a school zone, so I do not want to be hitting my gas right now. If you watched the last video, you already know we have a speeding ticket in the works, even though I don't speed. So I'm going to pull over here and get the POV setup going for you guys. And I'm going to give you a little look at this road, man. This is ridiculous. I am going to pull over right here. These are always the most ridiculous setups, but you gotta do what you gotta do. And that's our POV setup right there. No cops is always good. Beautiful, and we're recording. I hope it's recording. Put all that in there. And open these windows a bit, let you hear the engine. I cannot believe ChatGPT made us go here. Super out of the way. Road work ahead.
Yeah, I sure hope it does.
Probably turn off my four ways. If I could get this road closed off and do like an M5 E60 toge run, that would be insane. So the waterfront's right over there, but we're actually gonna keep going here along this road.
maximum speed of 20, which of course is exactly what we're going. Lots of boats over there. Nice little Mazda. There's a nice Lexus right there. I like that. We gotta get a JDM car on this channel one day. We're all German right now. That trend is gonna continue, but I'm hoping there's gotta be a JDM car here at some point. Well, I'm at least take you guys up the hill again as well. These boats are making me excited for summer, getting up north, going out on the water. To be honest, in Toronto, there's just too much traffic. Roads aren't great, and obviously there's cops everywhere. Not gonna be pulling me over, but they're definitely out there. Don't do it, bro. Okay, that's fine. Okay. Here we go. These roads are super bumpy. And we are back to our favorite workers doing something. If this little hill drive could just be stretched out to 4 or 5 minutes, I feel like that'd be so sick. But we are making the best of it. I'll rip it up that 30 seconds in second gear all day long, I don't care. But we are back out of the bluffs. Now we gotta see what ChatGPT wants us to do next. I'm sure it's gonna be something ridiculous. I am gonna turn around here at one of these.
Little, not even close to real thing, fake toge drive in the M5 E60, about 200 feet.
The M5 is driving super decently today. Honestly, one of the smoothest days of the year so far, I think. But that concludes our toge run. Our Scarborough Bluffs Toronto 200 meter toge run in the M5 E60. So I'm kind of feeling like a coffee, and I asked ChatGPT, should I get a Tim's coffee in my M5 E60? And it basically said it's entirely up to you. If you like Tim's coffee, which I do, you should get one. Please remember to practice safe and responsible driving habits. We are the safest driver on the road, let me just tell you.
We got a little decked out Corolla here. I am absolutely not a fan though. What is this, man? There's been a few Corolla builds that are clean.
That is not one of them. The good stuff. This car has so much bird poo on it, it makes me sad. Like ChatGPT instructed, we got our Tims, just a small double-double. And I think we're coming up to the last bit of the 24 hours here, where ChatGPT controls the M5. I did notice, however, that, we're just gonna go ahead and ignore that for now. We are a bit low on oil. We got 0.8, we wanna be at 1. So I think we're gonna top that up quick. We are back. And I'm gonna show you guys exactly which oil I use for this M5. The best and the only one you should get for this M5, especially if you're driving it for both seasons, winter and summer, or if you live in a place that gets hot and cold, this is the one you want.
Liqui-Moly 10W60, straight out of Germany, Synthol Racetech GT1
for the M5E60 and a few other cars as well. This oil is going to keep your engine running super good. Also, the hydraulics on the hood have worn out over time, so I literally, especially when it gets hot, I literally keep my head on the hood like this to hold it up. So we're just doing a top up. It only needs 200 mils. So nice and easy. Just eyeballing it. One, two. A little extra is fine too.
And that's gonna be it, you guys.
ChatGPT controls the M5E60, everything we did to, for, and with it
for the past 24 hours.
And I guess the next video is gonna be an install on the red ignition starter button. It's actually a little more complicated than I thought because it's connected and everything, so you gotta pull it out, disconnect it, all that stuff.
I'm gonna go through it in the next video.
Please like and sub if you enjoyed, and go check out apparelbyenemy.com for all your car culture, clothing and accessories, JDM, German cars, everything, all your needs are gonna be met on that website. We just released some brand new vintage JDM and car posters, go check them out.
And with that, guys, I'm gonna catch you in the next one. My name's Chris.
Thank you.